don't try this at home is a comedy film. And the reason why I wanted to do a comedy film was because when I was coming up with ideas for my directing film, I went through everything na parang gusto ko ba relevant or gusto ko ba deep or gusto ko ba drama, romance. Tapos wala akong maisip na maganda for me. So after a while, parang isip ko, sige, I'll just make a film that I want to make na I'll enjoy making. And since malaking influence sa akin yung comedy filmmaker, Edgar Wright, that's when I decided, okay, sige, comedy ako. And visual comedy, full-on absurd comedy, ganun. So don't try this at home. It's not just a comedy film. It's a comedy film about wrestling. So parang something that I've been a fan of for a long time na. So it's something I really enjoyed making pre-prod to post-prod. And there was a message that I wanted to say in the film itself. But at the same time, yun nga, I really wanted to have fun making it since it's my first time making a film of that scale. Parang sa wrestling lang, may suspension of disbelief. So parang sa film lang din, in my film at least, there's this sort of suspension of disbelief, especially since comedy siya. So I used that to make the film a lot more fun to watch. Pero ganun pa rin yung film. There's this reality embedded within it. What I wanted to say in my film, first off, yung medyo shallow, don't copy wrestling kasi dangerous siya, obviously. Pero second of all, for those who've watched the film, at the end, there's this spoiler alert na the dad will beat up the son for a very shallow reason. And parang wrestling kinda imitates or like reflects real life na you shouldn't do this at home, you shouldn't be this way in your family. There shouldn't be any violence in your family because like that's the worst way to raise a family. And I focused mostly on since my focus was visual comedy, I focused mostly on three things: cinematography, editing, and acting. Cinematography, of course, kasi since it's visual comedy, I made sure na everything that's in the frame, I made sure that I can try to get a joke out of it. So that's what I learned from Edgar Wright. So the movement of the camera or the shot itself, something that I can get a laugh out of. In terms of editing naman, since I'm an editor myself, when I was planning the film itself, I already had in my mind, okay, may ganitong cut, may ganitong pan left, pan right, mga switch pans, zoom. Certain camera movements that you wouldn't usually see in a regular film. And I already thought in my head, okay, ganitong ka-short yung scene na to, or this, I want this to play out, I want it to be one shot, ganun. Because I already had in my mind how I wanted to cut it. And in terms of acting, my actors in the film are all my friends. I didn't do a casting call. So they're all my friends from my other org. And I did that kasi, one, I wanted to make the filming environment enjoyable. And two, I found it easier for me to direct people I already know and am familiar with. So parang when I tell them, oh, ganito, i-elbow mo, or ganito, sipayin mo, I could do it to them. Like, in the actual directing, ginagawa ko sa isa kong actor. And I tell the other actor, okay, ganito, as in ganun mo, and then ganun mo. So it made for an enjoyable environment, but also it made for how I wanted it to be acted out. Challenges in making a film, of course, it's my first time making a film of like this scale since directing nga. So parang challenges, ang daming nangyayari pala sa film, filming process, pre-prod, production, and post-prod. Since I've always been stuck sa post-prod life since editor ako. So parang first time ko gumawa ng full like script and like madaming draft, ganun. So parang, okay, so this is how directing is like. This is how a director should think, ganun. Ang dami niyang iniisip in terms of like the film itself. So like, it's good to have a very supportive crew. Like yung PM ko si Mika, she always kept up with me, she always checked up on me, made sure na yung mga things na I shouldn't be thinking about like budget, etc. Like they got it ready na, sila na bahala. So that I can focus mostly on the creative process. Advice for other filmmakers, have fun making your film. No matter what kind of film you're making, kahit like drama, comedy, romance, third world, experimental, etc., etc. It should be fun. For the director, you should be enjoying what you do. If you can't enjoy what you're doing, it's gonna be seen in the film. So like with Don't Try This at Home, I made sure that in the production, sobrang like relaxed ng everything. There's no, parang walang tension. Like everything's easygoing. Like, oh, kuha kayo ng pagkain, may snacks dyan, may tubig dyan. Tapos mga 10, sige, G na tayo. And then in the actual shoot itself, kapag action, action, time for that. And then afterwards, sige, joke na. Sige, ganito, ganito, ganyan, ganyan. And make sure na everyone's relaxed so they can work to the best of their ability. Actually, before I thought of yung wrestling comedy film, doon ako nahirapan na parang, ano gagawin ko? Ano yung gusto kong gawin kong film? I was going through, parang, I think yung first concept ko ever na naisip ko is medyo dark. Something to do with mental health, ganun. Kinda cliche, to be fair. And then I realized na parang, I'm not sure if I'm gonna have fun or I'm gonna enjoy making this film. So I scrapped it and thought, someone, a friend of mine told me na parang, for my script class, I made a script about closely related to gaming, which is one of my interests. And he told me na parang, sobrang Anton yung script mo ah. And then I thought of that and I thought, why don't I make a film na Anton? And that's when wrestling came in, and that's when comedy came in, and that's when everything just came coming. That's when everything came in.
Kody, may coke ka?
Meron pa ata. Bakit naman?
Pakuha.
Gusto mo pa yun?
Oo naman.
Ah, sige. Balik lang ako.
Kody, anong ginagawa mo?
Ah, may kinuha lang ako.
Para ba yung gecho?
Mm.
Ay, naku, yung si Cho. Bait-bait na pa ata. Gwapo-gwapo ba? Di ba may honors yan? Kaya pumasa na Ateneo.
Oo nga eh.
Oy, akala ko ba nila kayo friends?
Shh, biro lang yun. Ano ba?
Ay, sige, basta maglinis kayo ng kwarto mo. Alam mo naman yung mga magulang mo. Tsaka mag-ingat kayo, ah. Ay, grabe naman itong inaalagaan ko. Ang kulit-kulit. Yan yung si Mami Sereno. Pag nagigalit, ako rin.
Kody. Kaya ulit natin yung superkick.
Na naman, parang naka-invest.
Kalama, ganito. May gusto kong gawin eh.
Ganyan?
Yeah, boy.
Gago, delikado, men.
Hindi, kaya yan. Sa cell ko lang yan. Easy.
Okay, sabi mo eh. Cho?
Kody, ano yan? Uy, sumagot ka naman. Nandiyan di ba si Cho?
Tumatae.
Ay, Diyos Jesus Mary Joseph, kang bata ka. Mag-ingat ka naman. Tas, ingatan mo rin si Cho, ah. Ay, naku, sana dito yan kumain. Bait-bait pa naman niya. Ay, mas pag kailangan niya ng tissue, sabihan mo ako, ah.
Cho? Tang ina naman, Cho, gising ka naman, oh. Cho, Cho, Cho.
Kody, nanay mo. Tara na, bilis. Baka na dito.
Hello?
Hi, Kody. Musta ka na?
Okay lang po.
Pauwi na kami ni Daddy from Tagaytay. Utos naman na si Yaya na magluto.
Ah, sige po. Sige po. Sige.
Oh, tas nandiyan pa po si Chum. Pwede na siya sa atin kumain ng dinner. Ingat kayo dyan, ha? Ay, oo nga pala. May sabihin pa si Daddy sa'yo.
Kody, huwag mong kakalimutan yun yung singkwarto mo.
Apo.
Misis ko na sinasabi sa...
I can explain. Cody, ano to? Hmm? Anong kalatang room mo, ha?
Kalat ba yan? Parating naman na.
Sabi mo, ha?
Bawag! Aray! Ay, matulit!
Respeto?
Pa! Juan! Ang
beses ko na sinabi sa'yo.
Bawag! Daka na ba? Ang
beses ko na sinabi sa'yo.
We'll be right back. kayo? Si Sir. Si Cho. Ma'am?